Colin, I have to say you're looking the part today, but in all honesty, you don't play that much anymore. You're more confined to looking after the juniors and the future of the sport.
Yeah, well, you know, you get to the stage where, I mean, I think all of us being PGA pros, you know, you take up a club job and you get involved nowadays, you know, with all the club duties. And obviously the main objective of any club now is to try and enhance your junior section. So I do spend a lot of time with the juniors, specifically these 2 months coming up now, July and August. You'll be flat out teaching the youngsters probably 2 or 3 days a week. So, I mean, but you've got to do that because they're the backbone of your club and the future of your club.
And what about Whitehead? A vibrant club, a thriving club?
Thriving club, you know, there's no point in telling any lies. The thing is, we're no different anywhere else. We're trying to, with the present day economy, you know, people don't have as much disposable money laying about. So, you know, you're always looking for new members. And, you know, thankfully, we've just looked at some figures currently. And it's nice to say, in the fact, we have increased our membership through hard work, through, you know, I have a lot of time for people within the committees who are unpaid positions, who put a lot of long hours in trying to turn it around. And obviously, with myself working with the office staff and all the staff in the club, we're trying to push it as hard as we can to move it forward in the right direction. But a great club and a great atmosphere and a good crowd of members.
Colin, the success of the likes of Harrington, Clark, McDowell and McIlroy, obviously they're the big names, along with a whole plethora of other young lads mm-hmm. that are going to make a name mm-hmm. themselves. Has that helped the status? Certainly it's helped the status of golf worldwide in Northern Ireland, but does it help at the grassroots?
It has to have. It can't have any other way. It has to help, because the thing is, when you take it into consideration, you know, if you'd have went to a young lad there, maybe, you know, before Graham G. Mack went down and won the US Open, and you know, Harrington won, okay, Pádraig being from Dublin, you know, but when you actually get a Northern Irish lad winning the US Open, you know, and then Rory came off in the back of it, and then his USPGA win, you know, if I'd have said to some of the kids there, you're out there getting a bit of tuition, you know, who's your favourite golfer, they'd automatically would have said, oh, Tiger. You know, Tiger Woods was the first mm-hmm. name on their lips. You say nowadays, who's your favourite golfer? Well, you get any one of the three. It's either Darren, G-Mac or Rory, which I think is phenomenal. That's very nice. It's very nice to be in a wee country this size and have three major winners. It's good times for juniors to be coming along, and they're the lads that want to get their photograph taken with. They're the lads that want. They all want to wear the tailor-made caps, because you know Darren wears it, or you know the Nike with Rory, and then obviously with G-Mac being with Strickland. You know, but that's good times, yeah.
A disappointing enough season, you know, apart from McDowell getting a couple of results. Mm-hmm. Disappointing, I suppose, when it came to, or whenever it's come to the major events for our local lads.
Well, you know, the majors only is 4 a year, you know, and I always say nowadays, I feel myself that a lot of the guys, what they do is they intend to actually focus on the 4 majors. It's probably understandable, because that's where people always remember the major winners. And I think that's where it's quite proud to be from Northern Ireland, all these lads who can always say, regardless if they ever win another tournament, they can always say, I won a major, you know. But, you know, performance-wise, you know, I think, me personally, myself, I think it should always be taken over the season. And so if they're showing a level of consistency and they're staying in the world's top 10 or top 20, then obviously it's there to be seen by all. So I don't read too much in it. I believe in the fact that all the boys, even from Darren, though Darren obviously, you know, he's won the Open, he's probably had a bit of a decline, but at the same time, I'm a great believer that, you know, form's only present, class is forever.
Do you think we're a wee bit, sort of got our head of ourselves a wee bit, the fact that we almost, because these lads have brought such phenomenal success, we almost can call it a disappointment whenever they don't win a major? Yep, you know, they're in the top 10, the top 20 in the world. That's phenomenal.
It is phenomenal, Adrian, but the one thing you've got to take into consideration is that, you know, it's a lot of hard work to get there. I mean, I think, you know, maybe even, you know, I've been at the game now 30 years in the PGA, and the thing is, when you look upon it nowadays, you know, 30 years ago there was maybe 4 or 5 guys could have won a major. You know, we've got to be honest now, they're all trim lads, they all work out in the gym, they all eat right. It's not all about getting to the bar and having a few beers, you know. We all know the stories which were Woozy and Clarkey and all the guys finished their round. If they shot 66, they went in and had a few beers. If they shot 76, they still done it, so it didn't matter. I would say the permutations now are a lot greater. There's more guys can win now. So, I mean, if the guys have a bad week, you know, it's immaterial to me. The thing is, I just say, look, tee it up, you know, put the clubs in the bag, get on the next plane, go to the next tournament, trade the same. You know, as I say, they'll always come good, you know.
I have to say to you, always come good. You're hot at the minute. because of the fact that for the US Open, you tipped not only Justin Rose, but you also tipped Mickelson. You had first and second.
Well, the story behind that, I was actually lucky enough to be on holiday this year, and the Bay Hill was cancelled on the Sunday. And if Tiger won that weekend, as we all know, he took over the world number one spot from Rory. And I was lucky enough that it were being cancelled on the Sunday. I went the Monday with my young son, Ben, and Ben took a hot. He thought that actually Justin Rose, I mean, he couldn't get over how well this lad Justin Rose had a golf ball. So the story behind it, to be fair, I would be a bit of a Mickelson fan. And so when I said to my son last week, I said, I'm like, we're going to try and take a few bob off McLean's here. What do you want to do? And he turned around and he says, Dad, I want Justin Rose. So I took Mickelson. So the son beat the father, and He's given me one for the Open as well, which I'll give you in a second or two. But no, he follows it well, my young lad. Now, he doesn't play a lot of golf, you know. He's more into his education and stuff like that. But you know, it's not easy picking golfers nowadays. As I said, there's so many permutations. But you know, it's nice when you take a few bob off the boogies.
It's always
you know,
nice to do.
There's what people used to say, oh, there's four windies taking your money and there's only one windy paying you out.
We're here looking forward to the Open. It's going to happen very, very shortly. Tiger Woods has had to opt out until this particular event because of an elbow injury. So who are the players that you need to be looking at?
The players, I always look for consistency. I look for lads that don't drop a lot of shots. I do read it and I do look a wee bit in the stats. Speaking to Logie and Stephen Hamill and Barry in there, and I was just saying to them, you know, I asked them the question, many Yanks at the minute are in the world's top 20. I don't know why you could answer that.
No, I couldn't answer that.
Well, there's only 8 in the top 20 now. We've got to take into consideration that you have got the other 12 are made up from, you know, the Europeans and the rest of the world. We've only got to look at the Ryder Cup in the last 5 or 6 Ryder Cups. We know that success has came this side of the Atlantic. So I look into the fact that, you know, if people are looking for value for money nowadays, I says you've got to don't back the Yanks and the British Open. You know, you may get in each way, but I don't think you'll get a winner. Going to, you know, obviously, us being local, being from Northern Ireland, I have to say, well, my son and I have to say, I would be a GMAC fan. I have to say, if you're looking for value, a wee bit of money there, GMAC will always give you a run for your money. It's nice to always sit there on a Sunday afternoon, crack open a bottle of beer and say, well, my money's still running, because I think GMAC will give you a run for your money. So he would be one. Another lad, I think he served his time, and I think back in 2002, I think it was the last time it was at Muirfield, is that correct? I think it's right. And he actually finished 8th or 9th place with Sergio Garcia. Now, you go back 10 years ago, Sergio was still actually just mainly hitting the tour then. I mean, we all know how good he is, you know. I remember being at a golf clinic one day. Darren Clark was doing a golf clinic, was a few of us down, and this is going way back to maybe the 97 or something like that, and it was actually down south somewhere, I can't even remember where it was. And Darren that day, we were asking Darren that day, Darren, what about this lad Garcia? And he hadn't turned pro, because he was playing in the Masters, he had to play as an amateur. And Darren turned around and he says, tell you what, if you can get your money on this guy to go in the Ryder Cup, get on him. And myself and a few of the lads were nearly bookmakers from Dublin to Belfast trying to get odds, and we couldn't get them. So I would say everybody serves their time. I know Rory's come through very quick, but Rory achieved what everybody was expecting to achieve, which I think is unbelievable for a kid to go to world number one, win two majors. But, you know, Sergio Garcia would be my pick. I mean, that's where my money would be going, Sergio Garcia. As far as an outsider, I like the lads to say, everybody that likes you, okay, I might be picking Green with D-Mac there and picking Sergio. The odds might be not big, but a winner's a winner. A 30 feet of one winner is better than a 30 feet of one loser. But the other hand, as a lad there, I do follow myself, and I have to say he's new on the tour, as a lad called, might get this name wrong, I hope I get it right, Thorbjørn Olesen. I don't know why you know him, the Danish lad. And if you actually watch this lad in any of the tournaments this year, he's not a lad for shooting 10 birdies around. He maybe would shoot, if he shoots level par, he could shoot 2 birdies, 2 bogeys, 14 pars. He does, pardon me, he does shoot the odd good number, you know. Obviously he has to, because nowadays you must shoot scores to stay in the European Tour. If you shoot 2 level pars every week, you'll not make much money. You know, you've got to be a +3, +4 handicapper on the Tour. So I think as an outsider, and I think looking at the odds there this morning, McLean's, I think he was about 150-1. I would get on him now, because if he was to click maybe this week or next week, the odds then just tumble, as we all know, you know. So 3 players. Obviously GMAC for the local interest, Sergio Garcia, and Thorborn Olofsson.
Thank you very much indeed.
No problem. You're welcome.
Okay. I hope you win.
So do I. Thank you. Thank you.